38, another logarithm problem, solve for x. And this time we got three logarithms. And again, to really do logarithms, we have to get everything on the same side. And well, I guess we don't have to, but it probably works out best. Okay, so let's think through this, because then we'll be able to combine them into a single logarithm. So the first thing I guess I would do is I would subtract the natural log of x from both sides. On this side, it cancels and leaves us with a zero. Okay, so we get zero is equal to the natural log of 6 plus the natural log of x minus 8 minus the natural log of x. I'll do it that way, right? We use our logarithm properties to combine all of these things. So the addition means that we end up with the natural log 6 times x minus 8. Make sure you get your parentheses there like that. And then the denominator, the subtraction, means that there's an x in the denominator. And that all equals 0. Okay, so we've isolated everything. Let's do the log dance. It's kind of going to be a backwards log dance. This is 0. This is the log of e, that's natural log, 6 x minus 8 over x. I haven't distributed this through because, well, I just haven't. We'll work with it later. So the log dance is that the base becomes the base, so I'm going to do it on this side. The exponent becomes, or sorry, the answer to the logarithm becomes the exponent, and the stuff inside the logarithm becomes the answer. 6 x minus 8 over x. E to the 0, anything to the 0 power except for 0, is equal to 1. 0 to the 0 is the indeterminate form. We don't know what that is because, anyway, we don't have to worry about that. We don't have 0 to the 0, but that's a good question. And this is going to be equal to, why don't I go ahead and distribute through 6x. So that becomes 6x minus 48 in the numerator, x in the denominator. And to solve this, let's kind of think of this 1 as 1 over 1 and do a cross multiplying. Okay, so then that tells us that we end up with x equals 6x minus 48. Right, cross multiply this way. Get x by itself, so let's subtract x from both sides. This gives us a negative 5x equals negative 48. Divide both sides by negative 5. And so that gives us x equals positive 48 fifths. So it's about 9 point something, right? And then we, again, before we rush into things like I did on my last one, I want to check, will that work? Well, certainly it's a positive value here, so natural log of this will work. Since this is, 5 goes into that 9 times, that's 45, that's 3 left, 3 fifths is like 0.6, 9.6. Yeah, I think so. So 9.6, so if I take 9.6 and I subtract 8, I'm still positive. I've got 1.6, so that's okay. Remember, in logarithms, you cannot have a negative input. And so we're okay with 9.6. 9.6 works. It'll be our solution. But they don't ask for decimals, so and they give us this fraction thing. So I think Alex is only going to be happy if we give it a fraction, 48 over 5. It doesn't reduce down because they don't have any common factors. That's 38. We're almost there. Two more to go.